welcome to JMI Live. Oh, you're welcome. Thank you for being here. We're going to start off this set in a duo format. Please welcome my husband, David Girvan. This is a sweet little duo number. We have been playing for quite a long time. And it's a Steve Swallow tune called Ladies and Mercedes. Thank you. Thank you. I'd like to welcome the most awesome drummer on the planet to the stage. He's been away for a while, but now he's back. He's going to deliver. He is. Don't look at me like that, Gary. I'm telling you. All right. Here's our next tune. Thank you. Thank you very much. You're too kind. Before that song, we played a blues, and that was called Chandra. It was written by a piano player called Jaki Byard. Not so well-known piano player, though you should all check him out. And you probably already heard him because he was actually Charles Mingus's piano player for a number of years. And that last song that we just played was called The Days of Wine and Roses, written by Henry Mancini, who's also popular. Oh, he also wrote, what was it? Pink Panther. There you go. Okay, we're going to continue. Thank you. A lovely Duke Ellington tune that we love to play, and it is called Do Nothing Till You Hear From Me.
Yes!
This is for Kendall.
Yes!
He's been waiting for me to say that. I've felt the vibe.
Thank you.
you very much. We're just having a band meeting on stage. I hope you don't mind. We've just worked out which song we're going to do next. It's not Shuffle Boil. So I'll move that page away from me.
Away,
that's right. Get it out. Okay, we're going to do a awesome Sonny Rollins tune. You'll tell me the name of it at the end.
Thank you.
Thank you. Do you know what that one's called? Yeah?
Shuffleboard.
Not Art Deco, yeah. And it's not called Shuffleboard, Gary. Jeez. He's been away for a month and he's forgotten so many things. But he forgets everything on a regular basis. But I'm not going to complain because he's good. No, that was called Pent Up House by Sonny Rollins. We're going to finish this set and I'm going to dedicate this to a student of mine who is fantastic. She's a fantastic student. She's no longer here at JMI, though she should be. And once upon a time I played this song and she was in the audience and she said, "Oh, you played that for me." And I was like, "Yeah." No, I didn't. But tonight I am going to play it for Samantha Sprunt. It is her birthday. Everybody, round of applause. Yeah. She made it another round around the sun. And this is a lovely Don Cherry tune that he wrote, and it is called Art Deco. Thank you. Jared loved it. Thank you. Thank you. Please stick around. There'll be a new group on next, and that is called Swingtet. So you want to stick around for that one. Okay, see you soon. Thank you. Okay, just bear with me while I sound check. Hey, 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 hey. Can you hear all that?
Hello.
Yes.
Thank you.
Here at this venue after studying here for a very long time. I won't say how long. And for one of my final performances, I devised a set of tunes from the 50s and 60s that I really, really loved. And they were general jazz party tunes. And then Paula decided that she liked them. Yeah, and so now we're collaborating a bit, and she's, you know, helping me where, you know, I need help. Which is, you know, good, considering I've got such a good pianist who's been experienced in jazz for such a long time. Give it up for Paula Girvan. Yeah! Okay, this next little tune, apologies to those who may have heard this story before. This little tune I heard many, many moons ago. I was, I think, a 15-year-old girl living in Ipswich. There wasn't a lot to do. Unless I wanted to go lapping. You know, like, you know what lapping is?
Yeah.
Yeah, you drive around town in your car with the music on. So I could do that. Or I decided to, like, do dancing. And it was ballroom dancing, and I actually, for the first time, heard a lot of jazz songs and was exposed to jazz. So this next little tune is inspired by one of my faves, Doris Day. And it's called Steppin' Out. Stepping out with nothing, can't feel bad, I feel so good. Ask me when will the day be, and I keep on knocking on wood. Stepping out with my honey, can't go wrong because I'm right. Ask me when will the day be. The big day may be tonight. Hey, if it's who you say, 'cause I'm trimming my say. With a pie chart on my shoes and on my neck. But I'm stepping out with my friend. Can't go wrong because I'm right. Ask me when will the day be? The big day maybe tonight. Ba-da-da-da-da-da-da. Oh, ba-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. We'll be right back. again. And back to the tavern she beat it, just as fast as she could run. He was her man, but he was doing it
thank you.
Alright, I'm going to take this little opportunity to introduce this amazing band that we are playing with. Everybody here is or was related with JMI, whether it be a teacher or be a student. I am actually an ex-student. I just graduated after 4.5 years! It didn't kill me. It almost did. So I'd like to introduce Marielle. She's alumni. Please welcome Marielle tonight. Marielle and I used to play for 5 years in the same band, Lady Thunders. Yeah, we did. All right, Kendall Lote on the bass. Alex Price on the saxophone. Alex Wheeler on the trumpet. Mr. Bo Jorgensen on the drums. And let's not forget, Paula Girvan on the keys. Thank you. Thanks for having us, Paula. It's been such a pleasure. Ooh! Oh, continuing with the theme of me obsessing over Anita O'Day. Here we go again. All right. This is from one of my favorite films of Anita O'Day. She gets up at the Newport Jazz Festival, and she gives one of the performances of her life. And, yes, it's called Sweet Georgia Brown. Sweet Georgia Brown! That's what I'm trying to say. Since she came, why it's a shame how she cools them down. Feel like she can get, must be fellas that she ain't met. Georgia named her, Georgia claimed her, sweet Georgia Brown. But oh so neat as sweet Georgia Brown. They are solid and wanna die for their sweet Georgia Brown. I tell you just why. You know I don't like that much. It's been said that she'd knock some dead when she lands in town. Since she came, why it's a shame how she cools them down. Their lives she can get must be realized that she ain't there. Georgia, and Georgia, please.
Thank you.
Paula Girvan. Thank you and good night.